Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to make a Tupac track without sampling. So what I've noticed in some of his top records, there's a very common drum pattern. It goes... So I know that stems from a drum break, but we're not going to use the drum break. Let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's go to X Drums. Let's find our kick first because we want to find the vibe of the kick. Now... here's what I see producers doing a lot. They think just because we have modern punchy kicks that that's going to make that Tupac sound. You got to remember these kicks are different than the kicks in the 90s. So the 90s weren't always the punchiest kicks in the world. So when you're choosing kicks, you have to think low quality sometimes. And I don't necessarily mean the kick is low quality. I just mean you have to think as if you are had that choice like they had back in the day. They didn't have all these punchy kicks like we do now. So let's go through each kick and see which one's going to work. So I like this one because it has, it doesn't have too much upper harmonic activity, but you can hear it through the upper frequencies. So let's program in that and let's go to our snares and let's find a snare that matches. I think snare CF will work in this case. Whoops. Let's go back to the channel rack. And what we're going to do now is just focus on these two for now. So let's tap out our tempo. Let's right click and go to tap tempo. So a lot of 90s hip hop was around 90 BPM. Funny. 91 to 93 are very common. 95 is very, it's getting into the fast lane when you start getting into 95, 96 BPM. So 93 and 91 are generally, the go-tos. So what we're going to do here is turn up the swing meter, okay? That is the way we go ba-boom, ba-boom. Instead of going boom, 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 it goes ba-boom. So what swing does in short, it changed the quarter timing to triplet timing. Boom, ba-boom, ba-boom. So anyway, it just makes it more humanized and it has a what we call swing. So to get the swing sound, we're going to put kicks back to back. So I'm going to go boom. Whoops, let's go to channel. Or pattern mode. I'm gonna turn on the metronome so we know where we are. Boom. Clap. Psst. So the swing is up a little too much right now because it goes boom. So that's the rhythm, but I'm gonna cut back on the swing just a bit more. There we go. Now it's a little more humanized instead of ba-boom. You know, it sounds like a computer was doing the swing. So just doing swing is not always enough. You know, a lot of people think just turning the swing parameter on is going to make it sound humanized. It's one element of humanized playing, but another element is time difference. So what I'm going to do is go to the kick, go to the wrench tool, and turn up what's called time shift or time offset. This is going to micro nudge the kick. Instead of having to move all the MIDI a little to the right, we can just use this parameter to delay the kick a bit. You can do the same thing by just moving your MIDI a little to the right. You're delaying it. And that creates a groove between your hi-hat and your kick. So now they're at different times. So now let's pull out a hi-hat. We're gonna go for a pretty basic hi-hat for the, let's do hi-hat FF. Now let's go to a new pattern. The hi-hat's gonna be very simple. Let's just right click, fill each two steps. Actually, we might do fill each four steps. Now let's go to our playlist so we can start combining patterns. So here we have pattern two, and let's right click the pattern icon to select pattern one, drag that out. Let's go to the playlist mode for song playing. Let's make it a little bit faster. So let's right click, fill each two steps for the hi-hat. So now there's a difference between the kick and the hi-hat. Now some like to leave the hi-hat as is, some like to delay the hi-hat. I found that West Coast music tends to delay the hi-hat, whereas hip-hop music might delay the kick or the snare, and the hi-hat will be on the lined up to the metronome. So it's your choice how you want. I'm gonna leave it as is. So what I'm gonna do here is insert that open hi-hat. Dum, 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 we have it right here. Let's open that up. That's from the X drums at BusyWorksBeats.com/X. Now at the end, there's a little sharpness. So now we need to edit the open hi-hat because we want the full character. I just don't want the little blip at the end. So instead of using the fade out parameter, because that grabs the whole sound and it fades the whole sound out. I don't want to fade out the whole sound. You can see it starts to cut out the song, the sound. I only want to fade out the tail end. So let's right click, go to edit. We can pull up Edison. And let's left click and drag the very end of the sample. It doesn't even have to be a lot. Now we're going to click on the fade out tool. And we need to re-import this into the sampler. So now when we hit the open hi-hat, it doesn't have that little at the end. Okay, so now let's add this into our open hi-hat or closed hi-hat pattern. And that's the pattern that you're going to hear in a lot of his songs, at least two of them from what I heard recently. Okay, so now that's the rhythm. Let's go to pattern three and let's start building in an idea. So we can go for the, how do you want it? It's the same drum pattern.
How do you want it? How does it feel?
You know, growing up with it. Or you can do the, what's this other song that I was referencing? How do you want it? And let me look at title as I play the loop real quick. It was How Do You Want It and In the Hearts of Men. In the Hearts of Men. Literally the same exact drum beat. But they're very common elements. So let's load up those common elements. Let's go to Contact. We're going to load up a live bass guitar. You can record your own if you want, but the trick is we want to make it feel like we're sampling the sounds. So all these plugins, they are high quality. And what you hear on these 90s records, they sampled from another record. So they not only lowered the quality in some cases, they had to filter out sounds to solo sounds. Like for example, the bass usually in hip hop, back when they were sampling a lot, it had a lot of filtering, a low pass filter, so they could solo that bass line. So you hear this kind of muffled boom, 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 boom. You know, you hear like a muffled bass. It's not like a straight on bass. This is how we have to think, like we're sampling, but we're not sampling. This is just a thought process. So here we have the Rickenbacker bass from Complete from Native Instruments. And let me take off any effects this may come with. I'm not sure. It looks like it doesn't have an effects tab. This might be the effects screen here, but it's not too straightforward. Let me see. Let's go to settings. I don't know. Let's just leave it as is. Okay, but if we hear any reverb or anything, we'll go back. So we have a live bass. Now we need something that we want to make sound sampled. You can use a trumpet. You can do just a synth line, like what was that one song? I totally forgot. How do you want it? We could do that, or we could just do trumpet sections. So for those kind of, I don't want to say lower quality, but for those retro sounds, I like to go to Sonic Synth 2 because it has those sounds that were from, you know, keyboards, those kind of trumpets. You don't really hear those anymore because everybody's going for this high quality sound, but they forget that the songs we love did not have the highest quality. And they weren't the hardest and loudest beats in the world. So you can mix it and make it a hybrid and make it loud and punchy in today's world using the influence of the old school. But if you're really trying to hone in on that old school sound, you have to think, how can I make my sounds sound, you know, not less quality, but how can I make them sound retro or like the approach of the person? So you know, as Sonic Synth loads up for an eternity, what I'm going to plan on doing is add in some trumpets. And I'm going to look for really lightweight trumpets. If you listen to In the Hearts of Men, there was a really like cheap, it was like a really cheap trumpet in the background when it when the beat breaks down towards the end of the song. So just listen to that song if you're trying to reference what I'm talking about. So this is taking 5 years to load up. This is one reason why I don't mess with IK Multimedia anymore. And this is not a diss to their company, but goodness, some of the plugins are just so not updated. Let's go to instruments. Let's go to brass. Let's go to brass again. And let's look through their selection. Now, they do have some great sounds. Nah, I forgot to turn my keyboard on, so let's crank that on. Okie doke. So now we have the mindset. Let's actually use that mindset. That's too heavy of a trumpet. We're looking for something pretty light. And I'm not looking for any effects. That's a good one, but it's... I would have to take off the reverb so that would become more retro. And also, it's very full. I'm not looking for a full, thick sound. I'm looking for a very thin type of sound. Let's see what we can get here. Let's scroll down. Let's look for the word trumpet. Trumpet one. Like something like this. Very linear, very vanilla. But when we add effects to it, I'm not going to add any effects, actually. Not in this track. Now what I'm going to do is create a bass line so that we have a little motion. So let's process the let's write the bass line, then we're going to process the bass line to feel retro. Let's go to pattern three. Let's open up the piano roll. Boom, boom. So now we have to think of a bass line. I like this tone. Boom. Boom, boom, boom. And we want to make it feel like we sampled it, so I'm going to loop the same thing over and over and over again. Instead of going up, I might go down on that last note. Yeah, I like going down more than up. Also, what you want to test is the velocity of each note. Because velocity changes the articulation in most libraries, sample libraries. Like some play softer than others, instead of very hard, which adds more aggression and upper harmonic sound. Let's come up with a better bass line. I like this better. Kind of has that Tupac, you know, influence already. So now we're going to send this to the mixer. Let's open up parametric EQ2, and we're going to add that low pass filter. Now the key is more than just low pass filter. You also want to try resonance. So I'm moving the bandwidth knob to add what's called resonance, or an EQ boost at the filter cutoff frequency. So let's move this down. And are we on the wrong track? Yes, we're on track 6. Let's save preset as, drag it over to track 5. So that resonance is also going to pick up, it's going to add tone at that specific location. So we're focusing on 1K in that case. Let's move the frequency down. And that's how you get that kind of retro hollow sound. And they use really low pass because they were trying to sample the bass away from the kick. So your low pass filter is going to be even lower. And you could try different sharpness curves. I could change this to, you know, steeper curve. Okay, so you can hear it's lighter on certain notes because they don't fit in the frequency range. Now let's add some kind of repetitious trumpet. So 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2. That's what I'm gonna do. Usually I would play this by hand, but now it sounds cheesy. That's the key here. Let's go to the mixer and let's pan it. And let's take off any effects like reverb or anything else. It doesn't look like it has any effects on it. I'm gonna delay it just a little bit with time shift so it can fit in that groove. So on that last pattern or bar, let's change it up. Okay, so we need to feel like we're sampling, taking small sections from a song, and then at the end, changing it up just like we were sampling a different section of a song. You literally have to step into the mind as if you're sampling from a record that doesn't even exist. Let's try lowering the bass an octave so that more bass notes can fit within our filter, because right now the filter is very low. The thing about really low bass is that for example, we can't hear that last note, so I need to pull that up an octave. I like it, but let's change the note every other so it doesn't get too, so we don't exhaust that high frequency A sharp. We really can't hear the tone because it's so muffled, but D sharp works in that case. But our ear wants to hear A sharp. So now we need to add things like we're sampling. So now, blah, blah, blah. Now let's clone and let's look for a saxophone. So I'm modeling the Hearts of Men. Let's look at brass, let's look at winds, and let's look at the saxophone. And, we need something that's very bright. I don't see any more sax. Could be in the wrong, let me search. Type in sax. Okay, let's see what they have here. That's a synth. Okay. A lot of these sound the same. Much difference. This one's cool because it's okay, so I hear a little more distortion. This actually sounds like the one they might have used. Let's turn on legato, turn on your portamento speed just slightly so we can do pitch bends. And I'm actually going to play a very similar I'm going to copy. Let's copy what we did with the trumpet. I know I'm kind of brushing over stuff, but let's paste it into the sax. What I'm going to do for the first note, however, is slide it up from the note below to the note above, as above, so below. And let's pull it up an octave. So now it has a pitch bend, and it's a little bit different than that first take with the other trumpet. And let's copy the other take. Let's paste that in. And again, we want to create that slide. So let's make these notes overlap a bit. Now I might have to change the snap to grid to 1/4 on this one. And here I'm going to add a note in because I want to do pitch bends, but I don't feel like using my pitch wheel and recording it. So I'm going to manually add in a note. And since we have portamento activated in legato, it's going to pitch bend. So that's how we can create those unique ones. And I'm going to slide here as well. So this should work. Now, I don't like the reverb on it because I want to keep it dry. Not that I don't like it, but I want to keep it dry. Also, the chorus might be taken off. Let's hear. I think the chorus kind of makes the sound. So let's go back to the playlist. Let's add this in. What I'm going to do here is lessen the activity of pattern 4 so it doesn't get in the way. So I'm only going to do on the downbeats and then at the end. And I'm going to create a nice time delay so that we can hear them separated. Pull this down an octave so it can fit where we were before. See, it's a little detuned at the end, and that's from the chorus. Let me turn down the depth of the chorus. Sounds a little sharp. So I'm going to pitch it down a bit. Using the pitch range, let's pull it to 1. Let's pull it down in pitch. Let me hear if there's even. I was trying to check if it was even working. Filter it just a little bit because it's a little too bright. Let's go to parametric EQ 2. Let's add a low pass filter just to take out some of that brightness. It was just too shiny. Pull it down in volume as well. Again, it still sounds. Out of tune. I don't know if it's because of the pitch bend or what. I'm not gonna spend an eternity trying to get it tuned. Pattern 5 so it doesn't act so rapid, and only leave the downbeats like we did before. Again, these sound really out of tune for some odd reason. Let me check the MIDI to make sure I didn't type in the wrong note. I think it's just too sharp of a sample. Let's try A. I don't know why it's acting stupid right now. That sounds bad. So anyway, I don't know why it's acting trippy with the pitch. Generally why I don't use these older samples. So my goal here is I'm trying to match the pitch of the trumpet to the saxophone. This one's going dun, 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 and this one's going bah, bah, dun, dun, bah, bah, dun, dun, bah, bah. They don't match, so that's getting really annoying for some reason. So let's just push it down in the mixer and just move on. I don't want to be too much of a perfectionist for a demo track for a tutorial. Some weird pitch thing. Again, I'm really not sure what the problem is. There's FL Studio is not matching with this plugin as far as the pitch. There's something weird going on. So that's annoying me, but let's keep moving. What I might do, let's do this. Let's merge these. Let's go to playlist options, go to merge pattern clips. Let's load up context. Session Horns Pro, just to get a more clear pitch, because the other pitch is so off, it's like bugging me. Let's go to Session Horns Pro. I usually don't even, you know, dig in this much, but since we're trying to go for that accurate sound, let's go to Solo Instruments under Session Horns Pro. Let's go to the tenor sax, and I'm going to copy the merged clip values into a new pattern. And we're going to paste that into this sax here. So now we can get a more accurate pitch. I'm going to take off vibrato. So we have more of a linear pitch. So here's something I'm going to modernize, because that other one was just way out of tune and it was not cool. This one just doesn't have as much bite. But if I switch the articulations, here I get a sharper transient. So since we can't have our cake and eat it too, let's just leave it at non-vibrato. Let me see if the velocity changes it. Oh, it does. So let's crank up the velocity. And hit Control A, double click, pull up the velocity. And the swing meter is affecting the MIDI as well. Keep that in mind. So that's why it's going bum, bum, ba bum, bum, ba bum. So I'll blend this one with the old one. So now I feel more accurate with the MIDI, because before that was so off, it was messing me up. So let's pan one left, one right. And have the one in pitch more dominant in volume. So that's our modern element. Let me turn on my monitor just a bit more. That's way more pleasing than what we had before. So it just shows how tuning is that important. Tuning can literally throw off your whole sound. So that's why I say tuning is the first step in all music theory, before you even get into chords and melody. So that's really it. We did the bass line, the drums, and the brass. That's all there was to that song. And then they had samples of like Richard Pryor on stage. You know, taking cocaine really as fun as it is. I can't do his voice. Now let's just do levels. The bass does not need to be the loudest element. And then we're gonna record like a verse or a hook idea to it. So very repetitive style, but that's how it was. And they did that because they're sampling. They can only have so much of the song, so they have to kind of loop it or be repetitive with the sample most of the time. turn off the monitors. I might spice this up with guitar or something, just to kind of add something new to it. So now let's get into the recording side, just to come up with a hook or something like Tupac, so we can liven this up. Now remembering the Hearts of Men song, I remember they added a piano in there. Bing, bing, bing. So let's add just three chords at the 4-bar mark, just as a turnaround spot. So let's go here to pattern 4, and let's come up with something, some kind of chords we can add. Let me see. Bum, bum, bum. Notice how I'm writing out the note I hear in my head first, then we're gonna go back and build the chord. So remember, we have that swing on, so it goes boom, boom, boom. You know, that swing carries this a little bit more forward, so. Anyway, the point is, before, if I moved it a little to the left, it would sound too early. So now let's write out the chords for this. Let's assume these are the top notes of some chord. So for A sharp, let's see here. Let me fix my keyboard a bit. What I'm going to do here is work down the scale. Now, I didn't map out the scale. I'm just going off of, you know, actually, let's not even worry about the scale. Let's just do chord codes. Let's assume this is the number 7 for our chord codes, and let's work backwards, assuming this is a minor chord. Let's do 7. So the minor chord code is 037. We go over this at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Okay, there's a lot more detail there. Let's work backwards. Let's do 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. So for some reason that minor chord doesn't sound right. So let's switch it to a major. And that sounds wrong as well. So it could be a tense chord because we're wrapping it up. We could have tension. And that fits a little bit more. So what I did was I pulled the minor third down. Okay, so we're doing that to add tension. So this is a little advanced, but let's assume the next chord is a minor chord as well. So this is 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. And this will be the same chord, just in a different octave. So we're going to just copy that chord over. Doesn't have to be the prettiest looking thing. This is how we add tension in chords. Let's copy these bottom notes and let's hit control down to add an octave. So I'm going to change up the bass to be a little bit different. So the bass, what I've done is actually taken the, where are we at here? So we're using the same notes we use in the chords. I'm just not using the bottom note all the time. So I went second note, top note. And everything doesn't need to be the same velocity either. Let's just turn this down. And let's give it a little time delay so it's not so on the grid. Let's go to the wrench tool. Let's go to time shift. So it fits in that groove. So that's what we're going to add to kind of create that turnaround energy and add tension in our songwriting. That's why music theory is so important, because we can add tension without adding more elements. How many things did I make? Let me see. Okay, so anyway, let's get back to doing the freestyle for the verse, and I'm going to freestyle verse ideas, melody ideas, and hook ideas. So it might just be a bunch of gibberish, and we're going to go back and figure out what works. Okay, so this is a practice you should get in the habit of doing if you want to write a full song or get an idea of where you can take your song, so you can go back and add more elements and see where they actually fit. So now I'm going to record audio into playlist as an audio clip. Yeah, Machiavelli. Death Row. Yeah. Step up with the tip of 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 the tip of
fly mode with 5-0 on the tops of the tie soul on my blind soul. And the pipius every cemetery, but up is up, so we rise. So we in the depth like Ben and Jerry's. Can I please get the beef so? And my numbers, can I please get the burrito? We smoke in the building with my cheese though. We'll keep it tight and put the top with the bees though. But we know we can talk about it, I know. And we know it's the time for the y'all know. And we know got the bass on the highlight. We know we got a lot all day long. And we know we got the plans on the highlight. And we know we got the wishes in the highlight. And we know we got the wishes in the highlight. And we know we got the wishes in the highlight. And we know got the highlight. And for the game is in the end, for the y'all die. And see the guy that got the ride, but it's all night. And for the time, it's for the guy, but it's all night. And we know got the means, but it's all right. And for the time, it's got the head, but it's all right. And for the time, it's the bottom, but it's all right. And for the time, it's all right, but it's all right. And we know. Placebo, placebo, it's a substance, it's a placebo. Cajizo, all my brothers riding out, but tidying out, opening up the business, sliding out. Provide the south, I got the who's, got the heaters. But go for something, get whatever's ever need us. Believe us, I'm on the top like a Jesus. I bleed us, and my pocket don't be bleeding. Believe it, ain't no reason to keys us. It's treason, it's a thickest in the season. I'm bleeding, hard body with the hard body. Oh, so is it broke, so it's cause it's hard body. It's alright, yeah, alright, alright.
So I did a bunch of gibberish. We actually came out with an okay hook. It's going to be like a call and response hook.
Yeah, Machiavelli. Death Row.
So let's send this track to track 13 or something.
Yeah.
So let me just focus on the area where I want to focus on, which is the hook idea, which is a call and response. I'm not going to sit here and write lyric. Okay, this is what songwriters do. They go through, listen to an instrumental, and they add gibberish to it. Sometimes they have words, sometimes they don't. Then they go back and they add words to the melody that they created or the accent, and they figure out the best word for that specific melody. So you don't always need to have words. It can just be gibberish. So let's focus on that area where we're strong. So it's like, it's like an R&B singer going, dun, 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 dun. And then Tupac's going, we know. So that's how it works.
With the bees, though, we know, we somebody I know. We know, it's the time for the y'all know. We know, got the bass on the highlight. We know, we got a lot all day now. We know, we got the...
So since I said some words, we might as well write it out just to show you the full process. But again, I'm not going to do this in every video. What I'm going to do now is solo this section and slice it out and then focus on building the hook, and then we can build this stuff around it. So I'm going to slice this to where we left off. I mean, to where we, ended the hook, which is this, with how many bars? 16, it's 18 to 24. So that's about, was that 6 bars? Oh, no, I can't count. That's 16 to 24. So that is 8 bars. Anyway, I'm going to move this section out and then we're going to build the hook idea. So let's grab it, let's pull it down away from everything else, let's grab everything else, and you can delete the vocal, whatever you want to do. I'm going to delete everything because we don't need it. We already have the vocal, we can always add it back to the playlist later. Let's just slide this up as a new kind of area, and now we can build on this hook. So what I'm going to do is say we know. I'm going to do that 3 times, pan one hard left, hard right, and then one centered. So let me turn my headphones down. Like the creakiest chair in the world here. So now I'm gonna go through and say, we know. So I'm just gonna do the ad-libs. So let's record. Make sure your mixer has the ARM disc for recording for your track, which is your microphone track. Hit record, audio into playlist.
And we know we got a lot all day long. And we know we got the plans in the highlight. And we know we got the fish in the highlight. And we know we got the fish in the highlight. And we know we got the fish in the highlight. And we know.
So at the end, I didn't have to say anything because the R&B artist is going to do it. So now let's do that one more time. And we know. So you could do it a little bit different, like, you know, a different pitch. We, you know. So anyway, let's record audio into playlist. I'm going to do the same pitch.
And we know it's the time for the y'all know. And we know got the bass on the highlight. And we know we got a lot on a lot. And we know we got the plays on the highlight. And we know we got the boosts on the highlight. And we know we got the boosts on the highlight. And we know we got the boosts on the highlight. And we know.
So that's all you have to do. Now let's do it one more time. And we know. So one time I'm doing we know. The other one I'm going we know. So I'm going do-do, up and then do-do, down. So now let's do up again.
Boy, now I know. And we know. It's the time for the y'all know. And we know. Got the bass on the highlight. And we know. We got a lot on the y'all. And we know. We got the bass on the highlight. And we know. We got the boost on the highlight. And we know. We got the boost on the highlight. And we know. We got the boost on the highlight.
Okay, so now I'm going to add lyric for the
da 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 da. Boy, now I know.
So.
Boy, now I know. Boy.
So at the beginning, I didn't know the melody for sure. So that's okay. So first, before we even get into that, let's start routing this into the mixer so we can hear it as is, and we can start adding stuff to it. Lyric meaning I'm talking about 14, 15, and 16. I'm going to pan these hard left. The ones which are similar, I'm going to pan those hard left and hard right. And the one that's different, which is we know, that goes down in pitch, I'm going to keep that center.
We know.
So it doesn't get too loud. Let's pan these things and let's turn them down. Because everything adds up in volume.
We know it's the time for the y'all know. We know got the bass on the highlight. We know we got a lot on the y'all. We know we got the bass on the highlight. We know we got the boost on the highlight.
So now this kind of blurry idea is starting to turn into something once we give it lyric. So now let's just add lyric. So I'm going to write it as I'm going because I don't want to sit here and explain why I'm writing it. I'm just listening to what I'm saying and translating it into rhyme words. So it's like
dope boy on a low.
So
dope boy on a low. And it's time for.
Okay. Dope boy on a low. It's the time for the something something. That rhymes with oh.
It's the time for the. Boy, know. We know. It's the time for the y'all know. We know. It's the beast on.
I don't know. It's the time for the.
Boy, know. We know. It's the time for the y'all know.
So everything's trying to be loud, so let me add a limiter to the master just so we're not. I know the video doesn't even pick up clipping, so it doesn't matter. Actually, let's just turn stuff down. We don't need everything to be super loud.
Boy, know. We know. It's the time for the y'all know.
Okay, let's write this lyric.
Boy, know. We know. It's the time for the y'all know. We know. Got the bass on the highlight. We know. We got a lot on the y'all. We know. We got the bass on the highlight.
Okay.
Dope boy on the low. We know. It's the time for the y'all know.
So I'm going to say, it's the time for the weed smoke. Something like that. I don't know. I would spend more time with lyric, but.
Boy, now I know. We know. It's the time for the y'all know. We know. Got the bass on the highlight. We know. We got a lot on the y'all.
So, got the something on the highlight.
Boy, now I know. We know. It's the time for the y'all know.
I'm going to go bar by bar.
Bass on the highlight.
Got the keys on the highlight. I don't know what I'm saying, but.
Time for the y'all know. We know. Got the bass on the highlight. We know. We got a lot for
the. Got the Benz on the highway. Something like that. Got the Benz on the highway. Got it locked all day. I forget what I said next.
Bass on the highlight. And we know we got it locked all day long. And we know we got the Benz on the highlight. And we know we got the bass on the highlight. And we know we got it locked all day long. And we know we got
so far, my translation is this. Let me mute the track. I know it's going to be a little delayed from when I speak. It's when you hear it, so which is fine.
Dope boy on the low. We know. It's the time for the weed smoke. We know. Got the Benz on the highway. We know. We got it locked down all day.
Wait. Yeah, I want to say locked down all day. So it rhymes with highway. Locked down all day. Instead of all day long.
We got it locked down.
So I could just repeat myself instead of trying to change up the words all the way through.
Dope boy on the low. We know. It's the time for the weed smoke. We know. Got the Benz on the highway. We know. We got it locked down all day. We know. We know.
So I might just repeat it instead of spitting here, writing another section. So let's do that just to kind of wrap it up. So what I like to do when you're recording in FL Studio, sometimes it gets tricky if you go back to your master track. So what I like to do is go to my master track, put Fruity Notebook in the corner, and then, you know, restore my playlist screen and make it smaller so I can see the lyric. But now I can go back into the mixer and go to the track I want to record on, so then FL Studio doesn't get confused. And people who face the problem know what I'm talking about. Okay, because FL Studio thinks you're trying to record on the master when you have the master selected. So anyway, let's select track 10, record, audio into playlist. The thing is, I got to click back on the Fruity Notebook to see it, or actually listen to this. Move the mixer down. There we go. So now I can see it without clicking outside of anything. Record audio into playlist.
Boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz on the highway, we know. We got it locked down all day, we know.
Oh, I forgot what I was saying, darn it. Let's do it one more time.
Dope boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz on the highway, we know. We got it locked down all day, we know. Dope boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz on the highway, we know. We got it locked down all day.
I was supposed to finish saying we know or something. I forget what I did at the end. So I'll do that in a different take. So now let's slice this one in half. Actually, not slice that one in half. Let's just grab the first take, go to bar mode. I'm hitting shift left click to copy it over, so I don't have to record it again.
Boy on a low.
And let's just pan this. And now I'm going to turn up my volume in my headphones, because right now it's a very low volume, so it felt unnatural being loud. So now I'm going to be louder in my second take.
Boy on a low.
So let's pan these left and right.
Boy on a low. We know. It's the time for the weed smoke. We know. Got the Benz on the highway. We know. We got it locked down all day.
And I'm gonna focus on those swing. We got it locked down all day. We got it locked. You know, there's a lot of swing. I'm going to add that in on this take. So now I'm going to crank up my headphone volume so I can feel the energy of the track a little bit more.
Dope boy on the low. We know. It's the time for the weed smoke. We know. Got the Benz on the highway. We know. We got it locked down all day. We know. Dope boy on the low. It's the time for the weed smoke. Got the Benz on the highway. We got it locked down all day.
Okay, so let's do that one more time. Send that to track 19. I'm going to pan it right, because when I'm listening to my voice, it's a little delayed, so it's throwing me off. So that throws me off a bit. So let's do that one more time. And it's okay to have a little timing difference between each take. It's fine. Let's record audio in the playlist.
Boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz on the highway, we know. We got it locked down all day, we know. Dope boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz on the highway, we know. We got it locked down all day.
So now I'm gonna do we know at the end.
Boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz. Boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz on the highway, we know. We got it locked down all day.
So now I'm gonna, and we know. So let's do harmonies now. Even when I have the regular Tupac one, I'm gonna do it twice. And we know. Like I can sing, but I can't. Let's try it.
And we know. Boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz on the highway, we know. We got it locked down all day. And we know. Dope boy on the low. We know. It's the time for the weed smoke. We know. Got the Benz on the highway. We know. We got it locked down all day. And we know.
So let's do that about four times, just so all the pitches can be a little different. I want to pan these hard left and hard right.
And we know.
And I might do, and we, I can't hit too high of an octave. I'll try a different pitch as well.
And we know. Boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz on the highway, we know. We got it locked down all day, and we know. Dope boy on the low, we know. It's the time for the weed smoke, we know. Got the Benz on the highway, we know. We got it locked down all day, and we know.
Let's do do it about two more times, panning them hard left and hard right. Actually, I'm going to do it three times each, one left, one right, one centered. So let's do it one more time in this pitch. I might change the pitch. I'm not sure.
Boy on the low, we know it's the time for the weed smoke. We know got the Benz on the highway. We know we got it locked down all day. And we know, dope boy on the low. We know it's the time for the weed smoke. We know got the Benz on the highway. We know we got it locked down all day. And we know.
Not sure of the first one. Let me solo it because I think it was way off.
And we know.
Actually, it was okay. Okay.
Down all day, and we know.
So let's send this to the mixer. And again, I'm going to keep the center panned. It doesn't have to stick out. I could just turn it down in volume. I just want an even signal.
Down all day, and we know.
So why is it something's happening here? Oh, okay, first.
Boy on the low, we know it's the time for the weed smoke. We know got the Benz on the highway. We know we got it locked down all day. And we know, dope boy on the low. We know it's the time for the weed smoke. We know got the Benz on the highway. We know we got it locked down all day. And we know.
So now I'm going, and we know, and we know. Wait, I did that already.
Boy.
Let me come up with a harmony I can think of.
And we know.
Something like that.
Down all day. And we know.
Yeah, let's do that.
And we know.
So I can hit that range. Other, you know, outside of that, I really can't hit that range. So let's record this.
And we know.
Do a little pitch dive.
Down all day. And we know. Dope boy on the low. And we know it's the time for the weed smoke. And we know got the Benz on the highway. And we know we got it locked down all day. And we know.
Let's do that twice more. Panning hard, left, hard, right, and then center. That's just my way of doing it rather than trying to come up with a weird stereo image. So let's record one more time.
And we know.
And do that.
And we know.
I'm going down in pitch like a guitar. Like if I were a recording guitar doing the pitch bend.
Down all day. And we know. We know it's the time for the weed smoke. We know got the Benz on the highway. We know we got it locked down all day. And we know.
All right, so let's pan this right. Pan this right her to the right. We're going to pan right her to the right. Put that down right there. So one more time, and then we'll be finished. So you can see how many takes it requires to get a nice full sound. I don't use plugins to thicken out the sound.
Down all day, and we know. Dope boy on the low, and we know it's the time for the weed smoke. And we know got the Benz on the highway. And we know we got it locked down all day. And we know.
All right, so that should be enough. Now I'm gonna worry about the lining of the words, because in my ear I'm hearing my voice a little bit delayed, so that throws me off the rhythm a bit when I'm recording video. So what I'm gonna do is realign some of the words, because some of the words are a little too early.
Boy on the low, boy on the low. We know it's the time for the weed smoke. We know got the Benz on the highway. We know we got it locked down all day. And we know.
Let's turn up that second harmony a bit more.
Boy on the low. We know it's the time for the weed smoke. We know got the Benz on the highway. We know we got it locked down all day. And we know. Boy on the low.
Let's turn down the first harmony.
It's the time for the weed smoke.
First take, I should say.
We know got the Benz on the highway. And we know we got it locked down all day. And we know. Dope boy on the low.
So I'm going to chop out all this excess stuff we don't need. I'm hitting shift to do a vertical slice and right clicking. Whoops. Sometimes you don't want to right click because it'll get rid of this. The audio. It gets rid of the shorter end when you right click. So right here, this is shorter than the audio. So if I right click, it's going to get rid of the left side. If I left click, and then I right click over here, it's going to get rid of the right side. That's not what I want it to do. So I just have to left click. I'm hitting shift to give it a vertical line. And let's do that for each track. And let's just slice off the ends that we don't need. Because this stuff in between is just like silence or me hitting, you know, my desk or something. We don't need to hear that. So, you know, I'm not going to do it for each track. I'm just going to do it for the bigger sections. Just to give it a better. There we go.
Boy on the low.
I might not move the audio.
Boy on the low, the weed up. It's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed up. We got it locked down all day. And we know. Dope boy on the low, the weed up. It's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed up. We got it locked down all day. And we know.
So this is prior to mixing. Notice we didn't do any mixing techniques yet. What I'm going to do is just level, and then we're going to mix in a different video for premium members. So right now, the vocals are outperforming the track. So I'm going to duplicate the hook. So I'm just trying to make the track compete with the vocal now. Now that we have the vocal, let's go to bar mode. I'm just going to hit highlight the tracks, hit shift, left click, and drag over.
Boy on the low, the weed up. It's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed up. We got it locked down all day. And we know. The boy on the low, the weed up. It's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed up. We got it locked down all day. And we know, boy on the low, the weed up, it's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up, got the Benz on the highway. The weed up, we got it locked down all day. And we know, boy on the low, the weed up, it's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up, got the Benz on the highway. The weed up, we got it locked down all day. And we know, boy.
So you can spend more time trying to align the vocals. I'm not going to do that now because it's tedious.
Boy on the low.
Let's just play it twice through.
Boy on the low, the weed up. It's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed up. We got it locked down all day. And we know. The boy on the low, the weed up. It's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed up. We got it locked down all day. And we know. The boy on the low, the weed up. It's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed up. We got it locked. Time for the weed smoke. The weed know. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed know. We got it locked down all day. And we know. Boy on the low. The weed know. It's the time for the weed smoke. The weed know. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed know. We got it locked down all day. And we know. Boy on the low. The weed know. It's the time for the weed smoke. The weed know. Got the Benz on the highway. The weed know. We got it locked down all day. And we know. For the weed smoke, the weed up, got the Benz on the highway. The weed up, we got it locked down all day. And we know, the boy on the low.
I'll play it once more.
It's the time for
I just wanted to hear multiples.
The weed up, got the Benz on the highway. The weed up, we got it locked down all day. And we know, the boy on the low. The weed up, it's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up, got the Benz on the highway. The weed up, we got it locked down all day. And we know.
Let me see something. Let me try to make this an intro without the drums. I want to see if this would work. So this is how you think about song arrangements, taking out parts. So I'm going to take out the dope boy on a low part, and then we're going to leave the, or no, I'm going to take out the we knows. Let's do that. Just to introduce the song.
Boy on a low. It's the time for the we smoke. Boy on a low.
So the bass line is like required.
Boy on a low. It's the time for the we smoke. Got the Benz on the highway. We got it locked down all day. The weed up, dope boy on the low. The weed up, it's the time for the weed smoke. The weed up, got the Benz on the highway. The weed up, we got it locked down all day. And we know, dope boy on the low.
So I want to arrange it, so I don't want the harmony. Let me figure out which, I think this is the high pitch harmony.
And we know.
So that's the regular one.
And we know.
That's the high pitch. I'm going to get rid of all the high pitch ones.
And we know.
Let's get rid of that one.
And we know.
Regular and.
And we know. And we know.
Okay, so now this is, we're arranging now. We're taking these sections and moving them around so it evolves over time.
Boy on the low. It's the time for the weed smoke. Got the Benz on the highway. We got it locked down all day. And we know. Dope boy on the low. And we know. It's the time for the weed smoke. And we know. Got the Benz on the.
So I'm going to get rid of all the we knows. Okay, so this is just, I'm just showing you how even if you do a nice hook, you could still arrange it like it's a song.
Boy on the low. It's the time for the weed smoke. Got the Benz on the highway.
If you look at it, it looks like a dog. Like, this is his mouth. These are his eyes. This is like his body. And these are like his legs. It's funny.
Boy on the low. It's the time for the weed smoke. Got the Benz on the highway. We got it locked down all day. And we know. For the weed smoke, got the Benz on the highway, and we know we got it locked down all day, and we know, boy on the low, and we know it's the time for.
Let me, sorry, I left. Let's do that one more time. Day,
and we know, dope boy on the low, it's the time for the weed smoke.
Now I'm gonna play it once through with no interruptions, no other arrangements.
Dope boy on the low, it's the time for the weed smoke, got the Benz on the highway. We got it locked down all day. And we know. Dope boy on the low. It's the time for the weed smoke. Got the Benz on the highway. We got it locked down all day. And we know. Dope boy on the low. And we know. It's the time for the weed smoke. And we know. Got the Benz on the highway. And we know. We got it locked down all day. And we know. Dope boy on the low. And we know. It's the time for the weed smoke. And we know. Got the Benz on the highway. For the weed smoke, and we know, got the Benz on the highway, and we know we got it locked down all day, and we know, boy on the low, and we know it's the time for the weed smoke, and we know, got the Benz on the highway, and we know we got it locked down all day, and we know, boy on the low, and we know it's the time for the weed smoke, and we know, got the Benz on the highway, and we know we got it locked down all day, and we know. For the weed smoke, and we know, got the Benz on the highway, and we know we got it locked down all day, and we know, dope boy on the low, and we know it's the time for the weed smoke, and we know, got the Benz on the highway, and we know we got it locked down all day, and we know.
So that's how songwriting is. This is how you take your beat and make it into something. You don't have to take it this far. I'm just showing you how a songwriter is going to approach your track, but you want to get in the mind of this exercise so that when you send it off to somebody, they have a better idea of what you want done to the track. It's not just like, here's a beat, do whatever you want. I mean, you can do that, but I found that when you give other people the full vision, they can create better or make the vision better. Okay, so just get in the mind of this. Now, it's not only for the person you're sending it to, it's also for yourself to know where you can take out elements, where you can add elements, where stuff throws you off, so that you can actually make your beat more accompanying for your vocal takes. So thank you for watching today. If you want to learn more about songwriting and the whole process of music theory and how it's applied to music production, go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. Thank you for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com, and the premium members will get the mixing video of this as well as the project files. So thank you. It's busyworksbeats.com.